and welcome to Paul Robinson's The Psychology of a Winner audio coaching program with me, Mark Tushel. And congratulations for purchasing this audio program as an investment in yourself. You're one among the many who play the game to win versus the many who talk about a great game. Before we begin this program, I want to take this opportunity to thank you up front for the privilege of sharing with you some of the greatest strategies that have shaped the lives of many winners. We all know that winners are a distinguished minority of people, where the majority of people admire, worship, and emulate. They're so influencing that they make us do crazy things like imitating them, dressing up like them, or putting their pictures on our walls as role models. Now, imagine a life without these winners. Empty walls. Imagine the world of complete mediocrity. No champions, no role models, and no inspiration to live for. I presume you got my picture. It'd be rather disappointing, isn't it? Now, if you are a keen observer to the success around you, you can witness the achievements of a few exceptional individuals and teams accomplishing the seemingly impossible, not just once, but again and again, in changing circumstances and under rising pressures. They're hitting higher than expected targets and making it look easy, doing it with more ingenuity and fewer resources, more speed and less stress, more trust and less time, while still managing to have success and fulfillment in their lives. These top performers have learned that just going along is stifling, settling for less than their dreams is mediocrity, and swimming against the current is rare and ambiguous. They know that if they act and behave like everyone else, they will end up just like everyone else. They surpass their expectations. They are the real winners. Throughout many generations, winners and achievers have not only coveted our hearts, but also they have significantly shifted the human potential to new levels of peak experiences. Many people wanted to know about their success stories. How did they do it? Is there any secret to peak performance? Are there any principles to winning? What makes some people extraordinary? If they can do it, can I also do it? There is an unending loop of questions about human potential growth. And as the saying goes, all roads lead to Rome. All the answers take to one specific direction, the right psychology of winning. What makes winners is their extraordinary psychology that gives them the uniqueness, the X factor, that separates them from the rest of the pack. This audio is about that unique psychology that is responsible for creating extraordinary winners in our culture. Before I go into detail explaining to you about the psychology of a winner, I want to make it a point to first define a winner. A winner is a high achiever who performs at an extraordinary level by pushing his own potential to the maximum. A winner exerts his or her abilities for peak performance to feel the bliss of achievement, adventure, humility, and gratitude. A winner is also a contributor and a pace setter who sets all new high standards. They're the top in the income range and become leaders and role models for many people. A winner is charged with purpose. Even though they face problems like any other mortals on this planet, they have the courage to break through their fears and limitations. Now, a winner is not a person who wins all the time, because they don't stop when they fail. Yeah, they do have disappointments, they do have challenges, but the way and manner in which they handle their disappointments and frustrations makes them ultimate winners. Nothing on earth can derail winners from their dreams, aspirations, and commitments. They are rock-solid, determined people, tough champions in all senses. Now let's learn from them and let's become them. That's what this program is all about, the psychology of a winner. In this program, you'll learn how winners manage their emotions and state of mind in areas where most people fail. Being a winner for life is an identity. It's an approach to life. It is a basic philosophy to achieve and accomplish something outstanding. It's driven by the human need for significance and contribution, to impact society by becoming a part of a legacy. You can develop the psychological identity of being a winner. One close identity many people have in their minds is an identity of a winner or a mediocre. Now, mediocrity contradicts achievement. We may not be aware of this identity, as this operates in the deepest level of our psyche. One of the major symptoms of this mediocre identity is when you say, I can't. when you say or believe, I can't, or I'm not good enough, or I'm not capable of it, remember, you are demonstrating the psychology of a mediocre person. Now, on the other hand, when you say, I can, it is possible by me, or let us do it together, you are demonstrating the psychology of a winner. A winner is a yes man who always says yes to opportunities. Now remember this, every great opportunity is wrapped up with a problem. And moreover, all of us behave in consistency with what we believe who we are. The identity of who we think we are matters a lot, as this paves the way for what we want from our lives. Who we think we are is a self-concept supported by our beliefs. Every day, with everything we say, behave, and do, we are telling the world who we are. If you want to experience a new level of achievement, all we need to do is establish a new standard, a new belief or conviction, or a new set of information, knowledge, and skill that can enhance the quality of life. Now, let me remind you a bit here. Remember once upon a time, we all wanted to be winners? When we were young, we did our part of dreaming, becoming successful, and having it all. Now, let's ponder this over. What happened to our dreams as we grew older? Did we get caught up in the reality called life? And we got so logically real that we never get to live the magic of life. Most of us are caught up in the doldrums of life. We are entangled in the so-called inevitable situations of life. We don't even try to detach ourselves from the tentacles extended by our limiting beliefs because we feel frustrated that life often does not respond to our terms. The dreams become shrouded and dissipated. There's no sense of certainty or belonging. We become strangers in our own lives. We feel that we are controlled by external forces, and we cease to experience our personal power to be in charge of our own destiny. We stop dreaming. The logic took over, and the magic withered away. I'd like to share some insightful and thought-provoking words by the renowned philosopher Khalil Gibran. This is what he says about reason and passion. Your soul is oftentimes a battlefield upon which your reason and your judgment wage war against your passion and your appetite. Your reason and your passion are the rudder and the sails of your seafaring soul. If either your sails or your rudder be broken, you can but toss and drift, or else be held at a standstill in the mid-seas. For reason, ruling alone is a force confining. And passion, unattended, is a flame that burns to its own destruction. Therefore, let your souls exalt your reason to the height of passion, that it might sing. And let it direct your passion with reason, that your passion may live through its own daily resurrection, and like the phoenix, rise above its own ashes. Could we ever think of a better metaphor for our wants and desires? It stimulates our thoughts and questions our beliefs. If we allow the reasoning or logical capacity to override our thoughts, then we pull the reins of our imagination. That would be the end of all new creations. So would Microsoft stop thinking about upgrading its versions? I doubt it. But if we are only passionate and daydreaming, as Khalil Gibran points out, passion unattended is a flame that burns to its own destruction. Or I'd rather say that our dreams will remain as dreams alone and never become the reality. The whole purpose of this audio program is to restore your lost dreams and to reset your mind, at least slightly if you may, so that you can make measurable progress in everything you choose to do. This audio program will help you to restructure your thoughts, alter most of the BS in your beliefs, and by BS I mean belief system. You'll also learn to create the right strategies for winning and execute it with the complete passion until your dreams become your reality. You're also going to learn the significance of mantra, tantra, and yantra in this program to develop the winner's edge, to push beyond the limits set by the rules and standards of dream stealers in our society. Oh, we don't stop at that. We get to learn about the peak performance strategies as well. So I'll conclude this chapter by reminding you to dream again. Dream like a kid who thinks beyond his reach, who allows his imagination to run wild, and think about all good possibilities. Psychology is defined as the science of mental life. In a mental life, we all have vision about ourselves, who we are and whom we want to be. In a mental life, a winner sees things differently than everyone else. So what exactly is the mental science of a winner? The psychology of a winner is about the right perceptions, attitudes of how we can look at something, like challenges, for example, and believing the fact that it is achievable to overcome any obstacles. So let me give you an example. What happens when you look at Mount Everest from its foothill? It appears to be gigantic and almost impossible to climb. Even though you desire to be on top of the peak, you cannot see the peak. You look so negligible and so minute. The fact that it is millions of tons heavier and taller makes you feel lost in its presence. Now, this is what I call valley vision. Now, when you look around, everything around you will look the same, or maybe even bigger than you. The unending path to the top, the big snow boulders, the tall pine trees, and the strong, cool breeze aggravates your fear about the journey to the top. From the valley vision, everything looks like an impossible feat. But now let's shift planes for a moment. Imagine yourself on the tip of Everest. Now look down. Look around you.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.